Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Still talking about how to import text files into Excel. Today we want to take a look at a file that is delimited. Now, on Monday I showed you the difference between fixed width and delimited. Remember, our file here has commas between each field. If we go back to Excel and we use File, Open, change the files of type to text files, we can then open the file. And here, again, Excel launches the text import wizard. It's smart enough to say, well, it looks like your data is delimited, so we'll accept that, choose the next button, and we get to specify what our delimiters are. Now, there's four delimiters that are built in: tab, semicolon, comma, or space. In this case, they've used a comma, so we'll click comma. Sometimes a programmer will use a completely different delimiter, such as a pipe character or something like that. If there was another delimiter, you could click the other button and type that character right here. But in this case, we have commas. The other interesting thing here is whether we want to treat consecutive delimiters as one. And you remember that there was a situation where we had a column here with the apartment number, and most of those are not filled in. So in the original text file, we had a comma, comma. If we had chosen this box to treat consecutive delimiters as one, it would ignore that field. That would be a problem. So in this case, we're going to leave that unchecked. I'll click the next button. Again, as I mentioned yesterday, we don't want to change any of these to text unless we want to keep a leading zero on the zip code. So we'll choose text here. Much simpler. When we have a delimiter, we can just click the finish button and we're good. Now, there's one gotcha to know about. Once you've used this method, the delimited text import, for the rest of the day until you close Excel, anytime that you cut and paste data to Excel, something strange is going to happen. I'm going to go back to my text file. I'm going to select a few records here, use Control C to copy, and come to Excel to paste. Now, normally all of those fields would be pasted directly into column A. However, Excel remembers that the last time I did text to columns, I was using a delimited file with commas. And until I close Excel, when I paste, Excel automatically takes that data that was comma delimited and breaks it into several different columns. This is a very annoying behavior because it seems to come and go. One day you'll do a text to columns, and all of a sudden for the rest of the day, Excel starts exhibiting this behavior. And then the next day, after you've closed and opened Excel again, you don't do text to columns. And when you paste, it all just stays right there in column A. Now, one gotcha, and I didn't realize this at the beginning of the podcast, is this behavior happens when you actually use data text to columns throughout the day. And I've done that earlier today in Excel. Someone pointed out that if you just did File, Open, and went through that text to columns wizard, this behavior doesn't start happening. So it only happens when you've used the data text to columns somewhere during the course of the day. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.